HCAM programming is supported by our viewers. Thank you. And by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services.
And by WPC Pest Control, a family-owned business for over 35 years. Owners Jim and Rebecca Mazzucchelli provide honesty, respect, and integrity, performing safe and effective pest control services. They service your home like it's their home. Welcome to HCAM News. Tom Nappy at the anchor desk to keep you up to date with everything you need to know about Hopkinton. On this edition of HCAM News, you will hear about a new way to access books online through the Hopkinton Public Library. We have highlights from Powder Puff Football 2015. Courtney will let you know everything coming up on the HCAM channels with our HCAM Insider. And we flash back to an incredible weekend in Hopkinton. But first, Hopkinton Parks and Recreation aligned with the NFL to start a Women's Flag Football League, and the first season was a success.
So there was a demand in town, mostly by moms, to come up with some sort of a non-contact football league for their kids. So through some contacts I had through other towns' Parks and Recs department, I heard about this league that's sponsored by the NFL. And to take a step back further, the NFL, as part of their settlement with the players' union, one of the components of that was to fund a non-contact league for youth players. So we contacted NFL Flag, and they provided us with everything we needed to start a youth flag football league. A lot of the moms who saw their kids playing were interested in actually coming up with a league of their own. Kelly Karp, who's actually my neighbor, approached me about starting a women's flag football league. And I explained to her that we'd be happy to sponsor that. Parks and Rec would be happy to sponsor that if she could get enough interest. That she and I could easily form a women's flag football league. So through those efforts, we did a little bit of, we reached out a little bit to some of the women who play softball in the women's softball league. And here we are a month later with about 40 plus women who meet every Monday night to play flag football. And it's been a big success. It's almost like a sorority now, it seems like to me. It's very competitive, they compete hard. We've only had one injury, thank God, nothing major. And they play for about an hour or so. We have some of the high school varsity kids who referee the games. I referee some of the games. They play football for an hour, and then they go to Cornell's and have a few beers after. It's really become a nice Monday night for the ladies. So, you know, hopefully it gains momentum, and we have enough for six teams next year. Currently, we had four. We have four teams. Would love it next year if we could get six to eight teams and really make this sort of an annual fall tradition for the ladies.
All right, now if someone wanted to get involved, how can they go about doing so?
They go onto the Town of Hopkinton Parks and Rec website, and you can register, or you could just call me at Town Hall and at Parks and Rec, and I can get you all set up to play flag football with the ladies. Anyone who wanted to volunteer to referee or to help coordinate or just to be part of it, it's very easy. Just go on the Parks and Rec website for the Town of Hopkinton and register.
All right, terrific. And the season is September through November?
The season is actually, we started this year with just wanted to play six or seven games. So they're playing, I think it started 3 weeks ago, and it goes right up through the first week in November. But if there's interest to continue playing, it doesn't cost anything to rent this field out. The uniforms are all here. We have the footballs. We have the lights normally, and we'll keep playing for as long as they want.
I play on the women's softball team in the spring and enjoy playing sports, and was a little bit sad to see the season come to an end. So I was trying to find something for women to do in the fall, and it occurred to me that flag football might be something fun, and I reached out to a bunch of my friends, and they all seemed very interested. So I reached out to Park and Recs, and they thought it would be a great idea. It's been a lot of fun. We're having a great time. I have had nothing but positive feedback. My team hasn't won a single game yet, but we're having a great time. We come out every week. We're getting a lot of exercise, and we're meeting some friends, and we're just, you know, it's a lot of good fun. So we're really enjoying it.
If you're interested in joining the Flag Football League next year, or would like more information on Flag Football or any of the other great parks and recreation programs, you can visit hopkintonrec.org. The annual Powder Puff football game took place for the 8th consecutive year. The highly anticipated game occurs the Friday before Thanksgiving at David M. Hughes Stadium and puts ladies of the Hopkinton High senior class against the ladies of the junior class. This year, it was an absolute showdown that went down to the wire. It was the annual Powder Puff game between the juniors class of 2017 and the seniors class of 2016. The juniors started off with possession, and Isabel Giordano started off with a big run. And we are underway.
With a pitch to Isabel Giordano on the right side. She's still on her feet down the sideline. Still on her feet. Still on her feet. Great run on first down by Isabel Giordano.
And then a few plays later, it was Isabel Giordano again taking it to the house to make it 6-0 juniors.
To the 20, the 10, she could go all the way. Touchdown juniors, gobble gobble.
The seniors would respond Statue of Liberty style.
Oh, Statue of Liberty! And Markula is still on her feet! Still on her feet! Oh, what a wonderful play call right there. You gotta love the Statue of Liberty.
Emily Markulitis would get a big gain off a terrific fake. The juniors and seniors each make a defensive stop, and the seniors get the ball back. Kate Wellzell has a nice run here to the right side edge. Gabby Lockett then set the seniors up inside the 2-yard line with a great run. The juniors' defense came up big and made a couple goal line stops to force third down, but then the seniors decided a pass, and Kate Wellzell found Elise Carlson wide open in the end zone to tie up the game.
Touchdown into the corner of the end zone.
On the conversion attempt, Kate Wellzell passed again, and again she found Elise Carlson to make it 7-6 seniors. Late in the first half, juniors showed off a pass attack of their own. Molly Bennett throws an absolute rainbow right into the arms of Emily Mastriani. That would make it 12-7 juniors going into the second half.
Touchdown juniors, what a play! What a play!
Seniors facing a 3rd-and-12 early in the second half. Gabby Lockett had an answer for that as she breaks into junior's territory.
And a huge carry for Gabby Lockett into junior territory on 3rd-and-12.
But then coming through was Caroline Johnson as she rips the flag from senior Allie Rodman for a loss, which leads to a punt. Nearly a disaster here as Molly Bennett had to corral the high snap, but turns it into a nice gain for the juniors. Seniors, however, force the punt, and Emily Markulitis has a nice run to about the 40.
Statue of Liberty! Oh! Markulitis on the left side! One play to beat! Ooh, nice tackle! No! Still on her feet, I'm sorry! Great run by Emily Markulitis.
After Kate Wellzell met up with her favorite target, Elise Carlson, once again.
Oh. Complete to Elise Carlson at the 30! And tackled at the 25-yard line. Elise Carlson is the Julian Edelman of this game. She's got about 5 receptions.
And then Kate Wellzell shows off her wheels.
Oh, she was thinking about a pass.
Oh, Kate Wellzell tucks it under on the right side. She's got some daylight towards the pylon. Oh,
she's in.
And we have a touchdown, seniors. Woo! Kate Wellzell gives the seniors the lead. It's 13-12.
She gets into the end zone for the touchdown to put the seniors up 13-12.
The juniors, however, had plenty of time left, and Isabel Giordano had plenty of gas left as she gets a huge pickup into seniors territory with about 8 minutes left. And then Taylor Velasquez, eluding defenders, takes it 45 yards into the end zone.
Still on her feet, she could go all the way. Touchdown, juniors! What a run!
The juniors then go for the two-point conversion. Taylor Velasquez gets the call again, and again she comes through, scoring the two-point conversion and making it a 20-13 juniors lead. Still, 20-13 juniors, seniors on their final drive. Kate Welzel goes to pass on the final play of the drive, and Elisa Gunnett says, "Not in my house," as she knocks it down, and the juniors take the annual Powder Puff Bowl 20-13. Congratulations to the class of 2017.
Coming up next on HCAM News, we will show you a cool new way to access books online through the Hopkinton Public Library. Courtney has our HCAM Insider, and we flash back to an incredible weekend in Hopkinton. A lot more ahead. Stay tuned.
HCAM News is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They are a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options.
And by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. Visit us at WebsterFirst.com.
Hi, we are the girls from
Girl Scout Troop 72969 from Hopkinton.
We would like to thank Mr. Trojan for the awesome tour of the HCAM studio.
If you are interested in fun and adventurous field trips, we recommend 1. Join a Girl Scout troop.
And 2. Visiting HCAM to see how local television is created and produced.
We also want to give a shout out to Kalala Supermarket to thank Dale for our Girl Scout troop tour.
And for always giving us a space to set up our cookie booth.
Welcome back to HCAM News. In addition to building a whole new facility, the Hopkinton Public Library is adding many features that allow you to download books to your computer, tablet, or smartphone. Adult Services Librarian Heather Backman gave HCAM News a demo of the new system, Access 360. Take a look.
Hi, I'm Heather, the Adult Services Librarian at the Hopkinton Public Library, and I'm excited today to introduce you to two new options we have available for ebooks and downloadable audiobooks. You can access them with your Hopkinton Library card. These are available to us through the Commonwealth eBook Collection, thanks to the efforts of the Massachusetts Library System and the Massachusetts Board of Library Commissioners. If you already use our OverDrive service for downloadable ebooks and audiobooks, the first one is going to be probably very familiar to you. It's called Access 360, and it's very similar to OverDrive. It's popular materials, both to read and to listen to. It's really a great place to check if you can't find what you're looking for on OverDrive or if there's a long holds list. We're also encouraging people to just try it out because the interface is slightly different. You may like one or the other better, but they have very similar content. So you can browse and check out and read items, books or audiobooks on your computer or on your tablet or your phone. If you're going to do it on your computer, the way to get to the website is you start at our homepage, hopkintonlibrary.org. You want to click on Books, Audio, Digital, and then on Digital Books and Audio Catalog. And it's going to be the sort of second paragraph next to the Access 360 logo, and you can click to visit the website. I've already logged myself in here. So when you get on the website, you can see it gives you a lot of book covers. Again, very similar to OverDrive if that's something that you're familiar with. They have an E icon if it's a book, and a headphones icon if it's an audiobook, which there's one there. And just like on OverDrive, if the book is checked out, that icon is grayed out, and you can place a hold so that you'll get added to the wait list for the item that you're interested in. You can change your display so that you can look at it however works for you. There's a search feature if you're looking for something specific, or you can just browse around. So let's find some good fiction. And let's limit it to things that are available. Using this filter up here, you can look for just ebooks, just audiobooks, or just things you can check out right now. And once you find something that you like, you can just mouse over it and you can click to check it out immediately if you want. I'm checking out an audiobook here. It's thinking about it. There we go. Now it's offering ways for me to read it immediately. You can also, if you find something else you want to check out, but maybe you don't want to check it out for the standard period, you want to have some flexibility in the date, there's a cart that you can add your books to. So you can add it to a cart. It'll keep it in that cart for 15 minutes. And then when you go to your cart to check it out, it will think, you can actually choose your due date within a certain range. So I'm not actually going to read this one, and I'll make it due tomorrow just so we can do a demonstration. And then you can just hit checkout. And it has checked these books out to me. And now I can go to my lists and items on loan, and there's what I've got checked out right now. Now, if I wanted to read this on my computer, I would need to install some software. You can find all of the relevant software and links to the right apps for your mobile devices here in the app zone. And they're all down here at the bottom. We don't have the software on this computer, so I can't demonstrate it. But what I can demonstrate is what the app looks like. This is the iPad version of the app. And when you open it up, it looks very similar to what you're seeing on the web. So you can browse. This is sort of our front page, but you can also go by subject. So let's find something good to check out. All right, so here's, for instance, some lists of cookbooks. And again, just like on the website, you can tap it to go into it, and then you can check it right out. And then if I go into my stuff, into checked out items, there's the book right there. It's currently downloading it. So, and then you've got it up on your iPad. You can read it. It looks great. And you can also return it from your iPad. So if we go back out, and if you're done with it, you can just return it immediately right from the app. And then the next person who wants it can use it. So that's Access 360, and it's really straightforward, really easy. Our staff who have tried this have been raving about how great it is. And so we really encourage you to go in, take a look, see if you like it better than OverDrive. They're both accessible to you. They both have very similar materials in them.
You can check out all the services and programs available at the Hopkinton Library by heading over to hopkintonlibrary.org. Throughout the past year, Hopkinton has celebrated the 300th anniversary since the town became incorporated back in 1715. This past September, the 300th anniversary parade took place throughout downtown, and it was an incredible event that won't soon be forgotten. In case you were away and missed it, here is a look at the incredible Hopkinton 300th anniversary celebration parade.
Thank you.
On another 300th anniversary note, be sure to be on the lookout for the Hopkinton 300th anniversary closing ceremony. The event is open to the public and takes place at the Hopkinton Center for the Arts on Friday, December 11th at 7 p.m. It will also be airing on HCAM later that week. For more about what you can expect on the HCAM channels, here is Courtney with our HCAM Insider.
Hello, everyone. And welcome to the latest edition of the HCAM Insider. On Tuesday, December 1st at 6:45 p.m., the Board of Selectmen meeting will air live on HCAM TV. The meeting can also be viewed on our live stream at hcam.tv/live. On Wednesday, December 2nd at 11:30 a.m., students on the Hillers golf team and coach Dick Bliss are honored for their achievements on a new HCAM News Focus. At 12:30 p.m., local poets from Hopkinton and beyond read their contributions for the Hopkinton Through Poetry Anthology. On Thursday, December 3rd at 7 p.m., the school committee meeting will air live on HCAM TV and on our live stream. To find out when even more HCAM programming will make its debut, visit hcam.tv/newsupdates, where you can sign up for our HCAM Insider newsletter. And if you want to stay up to date with Hopkinton News, you can also sign up for our daily news updates. As always, thanks for watching HCAM. Now back to you, Tom.
Thank you, Courtney. That will just about do it for this edition of HCAM News. On Wednesday, December 2nd, Golden Pond is hosting the second Shopping for a Cause, sponsored by the Real Housewives of Hopkinton. The event will feature a wide array of vendors, and proceeds will benefit Project Just Because. So you can get some Christmas shopping done and help out a great cause on Wednesday, December 2nd, 6:30 to 10 p.m. at Golden Pond. Stay up to date with everything Hopkinton by checking out our website, hcam.tv, as well as our Twitter and Facebook pages. If you have a Hopkinton-related video, photo, or story idea, I want to hear from you. Email me at news@hcam.tv. With your help, we'll cover even more of our community. For everyone here at HCAM, I'm Tom Nappy. We leave you now with the current community listings and upcoming government meetings. As always, we thank you for watching.